For developing economies, a large part of the productivity gap is that too many resources are trapped in smaller and lower productivity firms. Some of the best research on this topic has been done on Portugal. Now, Portugal isn't a developing nation, but it's one of the poorer nations in Western Europe. A lot of its economic development has come fairly recently, and it's one of the lower productivity nations in Western Europe. What's striking when you look at the data from Portugal is that the average firm size has been getting smaller for over 20 years. This relationship seems to hold up, even if we account for the fact that Portugal now has less manufacturing and more services, noting that firms which produce services often tend to be smaller than those in manufacturing. We also see in Portugal a notable tendency toward greater self-employment. In the late 1980s, about 1% of the Portuguese workforce was self-employed. Now it's about 10%. Why is this happening? One reason is that Portugal has very tough regulations and very tough labor laws, some of the toughest actually in the world. Workers have very much a protected status there. But this is the thing, those regulations for the most part are enforced only on the larger firms, not on the smaller firms. So to avoid these regulations, firms have become smaller. From a social point of view, this is inefficiently smaller and it means lower productivity. As of 2012, Portugal is in the midst of a financial crisis. The country could improve its productivity significantly by eliminating and changing regulations which give this differential advantage to the smaller firms over the larger firms. That would boost their productivity. More generally, across the developing world, differential enforcement of regulations and laws keeping firms inefficiently small is a significant issue behind productivity and economic growth. To read more on this topic, I recommend this source, which is available online.